What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Tenorshare channel. If you own both an iPhone and an Android, there might come a time when you are wondering, how can I share some files from Android to my iPhone, such as photos, videos, music, contacts, or documents? Well, wonder no more. In today's video, I'll walk you through two simple methods. Let's dive in. Don't have a computer around? Not a problem. Just install Share It on your devices. Tap Send on the Android. Select the files you want to share. Let's take photos as an example. Make a selection, then tap Send on the bottom. Hit the Receive button on the iPhone. Receiver not found. No worries, just tap the triple dots right here and follow these easy steps to connect to a temporary network. Unfortunately, Share It doesn't seem to work on my iOS 16.3 devices. Either failed to connect or stuck on the beginning of the transfer. But it did work perfectly well on my iOS 16.2 device. So, if your iPhone is running iOS 16.2 or earlier, Share It would be ideal fit for you. Otherwise, move on to our next method, iCareFone, which is a great iOS data manager tool. Before we proceed, let's move some files to this computer first. Just go to your internal storage or SD card, find the files you want to share, and then copy them to anywhere on your computer. Let's start with the photos. Make a copy of your selection, and then simply paste them out to your local disk. Well done! Now connect your iPhone to the computer and launch iCareFone. Go to the Manage section. You will get to the Photos tab by default. Then you can go ahead and import those photos to your iPhone. You can use the Fast Import or install the iCareFone app for a direct transfer to your camera roll. See, the photos are showing up on the iPhone right now. For videos, it's just the same. Move the out from your Android. And then do the import. And so is the music. For contacts, you will need to export them as VCF file to your internal storage first. It'll be saved to your download folder. Move them to your computer. And then do the import. Of course, you can also transfer files like documents, books, and bookmarks. So that's it. Thanks for watching. For more tips like this, subscribe to the Tenorshare channel or click another video to keep watching now. See you next time.